Welcome, I'm Philippa Jeffries from River Publishers, and today I'm talking to Marina Ruggieri from the University of Rome Tor Vergata and one of the editors for the River Publishers book series in communications. She has extensive experience in various applications of telecommunications engineering, and today we're talking about her experience and research interests as well as the book series. Marina, thank you for joining me today.
Thank you to you for the invitation. I'm proud to be here.
Thank you. So I guess, can you start just by talking a little about how you got into telecommunications and your research?
So actually, I entered the telecommunication field by chance.
Okay.
Because there was a context at the university to get a position of research and teaching assistant. I used to be a microwave engineer in industry.
Oh,
and
okay.
This context was in telecommunication. That started my adventure in the telecommunication domain, so by chance. Then the research through the years, probably also because of my background in the hardware and in the design of subsystems, moved towards a goal that I can really state I'm trying to follow since 20 years. Now. So the integration between satellite communication domain, terrestrial, and why not also aerial. So even if I worked hard in the field of satellite communication and I'm still very involved in that area, I always been a little bit strange from this point of view, I think, because I really look at from the very beginning to the satellite and satellite networks as a piece of a whole. And so integration has been my fixed idea from the very beginning of my research.
Okay, and you mentioned your work in satellite networks, and you've also been very active in the IEEE Aerospace and Electronic Systems Society for a number of years. What are some of the recent key developments for satellite networks that have really interested you?
I think that connectivity is a very important topic. And I think that all of us have experienced it directly in the past 12 or 15 months, how connectivity can really make the difference in actions to be taken every day. So satellite communications are a means of improve the quality and the application domain of the connectivity infrastructure. And that's why, to me, is an area that is really worth of research, investigation, and also of commercial applications. So it is a very nice area in my opinion. Now, what is happening is that in the terrestrial domain, networks are moving towards the paradigm of software-defined networking.
Okay.
And to me, that is a very fascinating area that is already started to be interesting also for the space people, but should really become the dominating paradigm in developing a future satellite networks. So that topic to me is a topic that is the most fascinating and promising for the future of space networks.
Okay, so looking at focusing on the kind of software side, becoming software focused, what are kind of, I guess, the challenges of that, moving away from the hardware and looking at the software?
Well, you know, software and hardware are so tightly related to each other. Mm-hmm. Because a good software can make the difference in your hardware.
Yeah.
And as due to the fact that we have also to account not only for the terrestrial application, but also for space, about sustainability, software is a friend of sustainability and can become the enabler of the enhanced flexibility of the hardware. So when you apply a software-defined paradigm to a network, but not only to a network, we can really talk about the software-defined everything approach. So you can apply it to data storage, to database. So when you apply a software-defined approach, you are looking for flexibility by maintaining as much as you can your hardware flexible enough to be used in a broader domain. So that's a fascinating topic, not only because I am a telecommunication engineer, but because I am a person who cares a lot about the future of our planet and of our space around us. So also space can take a very good advantage from following and approaching the networking that is software defined.
Definitely. And now something a little bit different. I've seen in the past you've spoken on human-robot interaction and collaboration. What are the kind of key challenges we face in this, especially as we develop further things like the Internet of Things and Industry 4.0, those kind of things?
So, you know, these topics are also connected with the software-defined paradigm. It is like a chain, you know, in which every single piece is connected with the previous and the next one. So the robot can really teach us to trust technology. As we started the trusting connectivity as a friend of us, now we have to do a little, you know, a step ahead and be a little bit more brave and trust AI-based robots. What do I mean? I mean that an interaction that is a cooperation-based interaction is a very nice future for this kind of enhancement for human activities and human efficiency. If we establish a peer-to-peer relationship with the robots, we will have all the benefit of having a relationship with a peer. And therefore, this is a trust that we have started to put in ourselves, to teach others to have, and to show that the human-robot cooperation done in this way can only be beneficial for humanity. You mentioned the Industry 4.0, but actually, let me say that the new paradigm 5.0 is coming out at such a speed that we have not really realized what 4.0 is, and we are still thinking about 5.0. Why? Because there, human robots will make the difference with a very nice cooperation and a very nice effect on the efficiency, on the cost sustainability of industrial activities. And you know how much this topic is important in this very moment for the whole world. IoT, you mentioned that, is another, let me say, pillar of the super connectivity. Because when you have human being, AI-based robots, and intelligent sensors, I didn't say smart, I said intelligent. That means a sensor that can learn from its own mistakes, improve itself, and be flexible enough to adapt to what is happening in the network. At this point, we have all the actors of our connectivity. These are the actors, and IoT is the way you develop these, let me say, almost peer-to-peer relationship also with the sensors. This is the super connectivity that can really help human beings to face every challenge, including the unpredictable challenges that we found ourselves in without probably having all the tools ready to go for facing the unpredictable. So that's the future, and all these pieces are important to reach the goal in the best way.
And going back a little, you mentioned Industry 5.0. I was just wondering, what is the distinction then between 4 and 5? What is the step up that we're seeing?
So 5.0 is the realm where industry starts to see itself as a vertical of a super infrastructure. So in Industry 4.0, you really can see that one of the verticals of the connectivity is devoted to industry and to all the activities that help industry to do better its job in a most in the most efficient and the cost-effective way. But let me say that the difference is almost the same that we are experiencing between 5G and 6G. So we have all the good, let me say, goals and the tools to do it well in one generation. But then there are things that somehow didn't go exactly right. And therefore, we are putting all the hopes in the transition to the new generation.
Yeah.
In my opinion, but it's my personal opinion, and somebody can naturally disagree with me about that. Between 4.0 and 5.0 in the industry domain, we are almost living the same thing. Because of true industry 4.0, we have really understood how much technology can help life in industry. But now we want something more. Mm-hmm. So we really want, for instance, the tight cooperation between human beings and AI-based algorithms and machines. And we want to be considered in industry 5.0 as a vertical not only of a fixed connectivity, but also on the mobile connectivity. So somehow the break-even point will be when 6.6G and 5.0 will meet, and 5.0 will become one of the major verticals of the 6G approach. Also because these two domains will be characterized by one common word, beside naturally connectivity, that would be sustainability. In industry 5.0, you cannot exist if you are not sustainable and environmental prone in your activities.
Okay, thank you. And just to finish, you are one of our editors for our series in communications, which encompasses a variety of topics in communication and network systems. I was just wondering, what do you think are some of the key technologies or research that's coming out in this area at the moment that we could perhaps look forward to books, seeing books in?
So we actually are, let me say, in the core of the possible topics, because communications, even if the world can very quickly become something like super connectivity, super infrastructure, but communication is the core, because everything is related to our capability of connecting one or more points and bringing the data that can be any type of data now between the two correspondent, the two or more correspondents. So communication is by itself the core of the core of technology. But now the real challenge, as we mentioned, the many topics that are really going in the direction of an advancement in the communication domain. The software definition applied to everything, including space, the sensors are becoming active and intelligent in the network, the peer-to-peer human-robot communication. But also, let me tell you that everything is synthesized by, to me, the topic of the topic. That is the super approach to 6G. The right approach to 6G. Mm-hmm. Everybody's talking about 6G.
Yeah.
But did we pose ourselves a serious question about the fact that 6G, if done properly, can change really the perspectives of human beings by being sustainable, by integrating different environments, because this is in the goals, not to cover space, undersea. So you have users in places where you didn't imagine to have users for a mobile generation system. But we have to do it properly. So things and components, space, terrestrial, aerial, sea related, should talk each other in order to avoid to have duplications, because this means sustainability, no? That we only do what is needed and we make a kind of recyclable approach to things. So 6G could be the topic of the topics for the core of the core, the communication system, to launch the message and educate people to the sustainable approach to technology, to connectivity, and to the application realms of connectivities.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm afraid we have to end it there, but thank you for joining me, Marina. It's been really interesting.
Thank you, Philippa.